टुडे आई रिमेंबर द डिवाइन सेंट हज़रत बाबा जान। हज़रत बाबा जान वॉज अ ग्रेट सूफी सेंट एंड हर दरगाह श्राइन इज़ इन द हार्ट ऑफ पुणे सिटी। हज़रत बाबा जान इज़ द ओनली वुमन सूफी सेंट, द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ ऑल, एंड शी लुक्स सो हम्बल, सो स्वीट। आई हम्बली सैल्यूट टू हर होलीनेस हज़रत बाबा जान। अ ब्यूटिफुल पिक्चर ऑफ हज़रत बाबा जान, द एम्परर, द मसीहा, हुज ग्रेस एंड लव इज स्टिल एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय मेनी डिवोटीज हु विजिट हर दरगाह। It is not only the men who have attained the peak of enlightenment, but also several women who have revolutionized the world with their divine message. One of them is Hazrat Baba Jan. And there is a story, a wonderful story, a real life incident that happened between Hazrat Baba Jan and Meher Baba. A beautiful incident, so much that it has touched my heart and it will touch the heart of all those meditative souls who are listening to this podcast. It happened in Bombay. It happened with a kiss from Hazrat Baba Jan. Meher Baba was just passing, coming back from his school. He must be not more than 12 years old. Hazrat Baba Jan was just sitting under a tree for years and years and years. Meher Baba was just coming and Baba Jan called him. He knew this old lady. She had been sitting for years under the tree, and he had passed by that street daily on his way towards his school and towards his home. She called and he came near. She kissed him and he dropped as if dead just there. Then he had to be carried home. For 1 year continuously, the kiss remained on him and he was in coma. It may happen suddenly like this. This was a great transfer, and Hazrat Baba Jan died afterward because she had just been waiting for this moment. To give someone the whole energy, this was her last life. And there was not enough time even to explain what she was giving, and also she was not the type to have explained. She was a silent mystic. She had not touched anybody for years. She was only waiting for this moment when she was to kiss someone, and the whole energy was to be transferred in a single transfer. Before this, she had not even touched anyone, so this touch was to be total. When the divine touch, when the realization, when the enlightenment happens, all actions stop. Because desires no more exist, many desires will drop and many actions also. Those actions which were just caused by desires will drop. If I was running for a particular desire, how can I run if the desire has dropped? My running will stop. At least the same running on the same route will stop. So when a person becomes desireless, at least for an interim period, for an interval, and how long it will be, will depend on the individual. He will become inactive. The desires will have dropped, and all the actions that he had been doing were concerned with desires. So how can he continue? They will drop. One may also go into a coma. That is how Meher Baba, with that divine touch of Hazrat Baba Jan, went into a coma. Because all desires vanished with that one divine kiss. And when there is absolutely no desire, there is no action. You almost go into a deep sleep to which the world may address as coma. After 1 year of coma, Meher Baba opened his eyes. His eyes were the same, but his perspective towards life had changed, totally changed. Everything around him was the same, but he was no more the same. Great spiritual energy, a great light had come to his heart. The transferring had happened spontaneously. With just one divine kiss, the Hazrat had passed on herself to Meher Baba. How deep must be the love between them? How deep must be the connection of many past lives between them? Meher Baba, the man who revolutionized the world, traveled around the world and transformed many madmen into enlightened beings. It is a strange world. Here, really great things are never rewarded. Nobody has bothered about Meher Baba. Mother Teresa will get a Nobel Prize because she looks after poor orphan children. And nobody thought of giving a Nobel Prize to Meher Baba, who really did a miraculous job, and he was the only man after centuries. Meher Baba remained silent for most of his life. He never spoke, but without speaking a single word, he transformed many lives. Meher Baba says, "Desire nothing except desirelessness. Hope for nothing except to rise above all hopes. Want nothing and you will have everything." The question, or rather the focus, should be on how we can focus within. That's Ketu. Millions and millions of births and rebirths we have taken, and still, if we are fascinated by the exaltation of Rahu, still if we are intrigued by the glamour of Rahu, then somewhere we are missing the real thing, and that is the greatest tragedy of this human life. Let us all move away from Rahu, the ignorance that leads to many desires, and let us all move towards Sri Ketu, the source towards yourself. The whole story of human life is between these two ends, Rahu and Ketu, ignorance and consciousness, desires and desirelessness. If the fake gold, the gold that you consider to be real gold, shines so much, then imagine, just imagine how much the gold within you will shine, how much the light within you can shine. But to realize the gold within you, all that is rubbish, all that is doing no good to yourself, has to be thrown out so that you can come to the purest gold within you. The irony is that people are behind the gold that can be bought on the outside, whereas I am encouraging you all to focus on the gold that is within you. The gold that is within you is going to be with you. The gold that you have in your lockers can be stolen, but the gold that is within you cannot be stolen. Nobody can take it away from you. It is truly yours. You are already a masterpiece. You are already a light. You just have to come to the point of realization, and then there is a song to it, a dance. Drop the idea of becoming someone, because you are already a masterpiece. You cannot be improved. You have only to come to it, to know it, to realize it. Spend some time in meditation. Spend some quality time with yourself. To each person who is listening to this podcast, I tell you, you are a beautiful person. Focus on your heart. Follow your heart. Overcome the mind and reach towards the depth of your heart. Of all the readers and of all the listeners, if one starts meditating, I would consider that my podcast, my sharing have fructified, have become a full moon, have lived up to a certain cause. Being a candle is not easy. In order to give light, one must first burn. Always remember, one candle can light thousands of candles. Be that one candle. Meditate.